Let your escort, lion-hearted, be summoned to receive a general's blessing. Ere they depart upon their dread adventure.
Dear sir, they come.
This tale.
Ta-ra, 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 ta-ra.
We uncomfortable feel.
Ta-ra, ta-ra.
And we find the wisest thing.
Ta-ra, 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 ta-ra.
Is to slap our chests and.
Ta-ra, ta-ra.
For when threatened with the mutes.
Ta-ra, 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 ta-ra.
And your army in your butte.
Ta-ra, ta-ra.
There is nothing brings it round like the trumpet's martial sound, like the trumpet's martial sound.
Tarantara, tarantara,
so was it evident.
Ta-ra, ta-ra, ta-ra.
These attentions be well meant.
Ta-ra, ta-ra.
Such expressions don't appear.
Ta-ra, 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 ta-ra.
Calculated men to cheer.
Ta-ra, ta-ra.
Who are going to meet their fate in a highly nervous state.
Ta-ra, 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 ta-ra.
Still to us it's evident these attentions be well meant.
Ta-ra, 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 ta-ra.
Go and do your best endeavor, and before our limbs may sever, we will say farewell forever. Go to glory and the grave.
Go to glory and the grave. Though your foes are fierce and truthless, false and merciful, and truth is young yet tender, old and truth is all in vain, the mercy crave.
We observe to greater stress on the list that honors press, and of reference alack to our chance of coming back. Still, perhaps it would be wise not to carp or criticize, for it's very evident that these attentions are well meant.
Yes, it's very evident these attentions are well meant. Evident, yes, well meant. Evident, ah, yes, well meant. When the foe wears his steel, tarantara, tarantara.
pirate's lair. Oh, joy unbounded! Oh, sweet relief! Oh, rapture unexampled! And lest I may atone in some slight measure for the repeated acts of theft and pillage, which in a sense of duty's stern dictation, I, circumstance's victim, have been guilty.
Young Frederick.
Who calls?
Your late commander.
And I, your little room.
Oh, mad intruders, how dare ye face me? Know ye not, O rash ones, that I have doomed you to extermination?
Have mercy on us. Here is a slaughter.
I do not think I ought to listen to you. Yet mercy should alloy our stern resentment. And so I will be merciful. Say on.
When you had left a pirate fall, we tried to raise our spirits faint, according to the custom, always quip and quibble quaint. But all in vain the quips we heard. We lay and stopped upon the rocks, until tongues on board the occurred a startling paradox.
A paradox.
A paradox, a most ingenious paradox. We quips and quibbles heard it mocked, but not to be the paradox.
A paradox, a paradox, a most ingenious paradox.
A paradox.
Oh, I can't wait to hear
this. Listen to me, my boy.
Oh.
We knew your taste for curious quips, for cranks and contradictions queer, and with the laughter on our lips, we'd wished you there to hear. We said if we could tell it him, how Frederick would the joke enjoy. And so we've risked both life and limb to tell it to our boy.
That paradox.
That paradox, that most ingenious paradox. We quips and quibbles, heard in flocks, but none to beat this paradox.
A paradox, a paradox, a most ingenious paradox.
A paradox.
Oh, I love a good paradox.
For some ridiculous reason, to which, however, I have no desire to be disloyal. Some person in authority.
Who?
I don't know who. Very likely the great astronomer royal has decided that for although such a beastly month as February, 28 days as a rule are plenty. 1 year in every 4, his days shall be reckoned as 29. Through some singular coincidence, I shouldn't be surprised if it were owing to the agency of an ill-natured fairy. You are the victim of this clumsy arrangement, having been born in leap year on the 29th of February. And so, by simple arithmetical process, you'll easily discover that though you've lived 21 years, yet, if we go by birthdays, you're only 5 and a little bit over.
Dear me, let's see. Yes, yes, with yours my figures do agree. How quaint the ways of paradox. At common sense she gaily mocks. Though counting in the usual way is 21 I've been alive, yet reckoning by my natal day, yet reckoning by my natal day. I am a little boy of 5!
He's a little boy of five! A paradox, a paradox, a most ingenious paradox. A paradox. A curious paradox. A most ingenious paradox.
most absurdly whimsical. 5 1/4. No one would think it's a liquid moon.
You'll be glad now, I'll be bound, that you spared us. You'd never have forgiven yourself when you discovered you had killed 2 of your comrades.
My comrades?
Yes.
I'm afraid you don't realise the delicacy of your position. You were apprenticed to us.
Yes, until I reached my 21st year.
No. Until you reached your 21st birthday. And going by birthdays, you're only 5 1/4.
You don't mean to say you're going to hold me to this.
Oh, we merely remind you of the fact and leave the rest to your sense of duty.
Your sense of duty?
Don't put it on that footing. As I was merciful to you just now, be merciful to me. I implore you not to insist on the lesser of your bond, just as the cup of happiness is in my lips.
We insist on nothing. We content ourselves with pointing out to you your duty.
Your duty?
Well, you have appealed to my sense of duty, and my duty is only too clear. Oh, I abhor your infamous calling! I shudder at the thought that I was ever mixed up with you! But duty is before all, and at any price I will do my duty.
Bravely spoken.
Lead on.
Come! You are one of us once more.
I follow. Oh, horror!
What is the matter?
Oh, ought I to tell you? No, I cannot.
Speak out. I charge you by that sense of conscientiousness to which we have never yet appealed in vain.
General Stanley.
Yes. Yes.
The father of my Mabel.
Yes.
He escaped from you on the plea that he was an orphan.
He did?
Oh, he did. I was there.
No, I cannot do it. It breaks my heart to betray the honored father of the girl that I adore.
Break it.
But as your apprentice, I have no alternative.
None.
It is my duty to tell you that General Stanley is no orphan.
What?
More than that, he never was one.
Ah!
Do you mean to tell me that to save his contemptible life, he dared to practice on our credulous simplicity? Our revenge shall be swift and terrible. You will go and collect our band and attract Tremorden Castle this very night.
But stay!
Not a word! He is doomed!
Away, away, my heart's on fire. I burn this base deception to repay. This very night, my vengeance dire shall cut itself in gore. Away, away!
Away, away, ere I expire, I find my duty hard to do today. My heart is filled with anguish dire. It strikes me to the core, away, away.
With thoughts of foul instructors of our pride, let vengeance howl the pirate so decides. Our nature's stern is softened with his lies, and in return tonight the traitor dies.
Yes, yes, tonight the traitor dies.
Yes, yes, tonight the traitor dies.
Tonight he dies.
Yes, the rule is tomorrow.
Girls likewise.
They will welter in sorrow.
The ones are spots.
In their natures they cherish.
And all who plot.
To appear they shall perish.
Tonight, so early tomorrow. It's girls like wise will welter in sorrow. The ones are spots in their natures they cherish. And all who plot to appear they shall perish.
Away, away,
away, away.
Away.
my dearly loved one. I bound myself to serve the pirate captain until I reached my 21st birthday.
But you are 21.
I've just discovered that I was born in leap year, and that birthday will not be reached by me till 1940.
Oh, horrible. It has to be appalling.
And so farewell.
Thank you.
In 1940 I then of age shall be. I'll then return and claim you, I declare it.
It seems so long.
Swear that till then you'll be true to me.
Yes, love is strong. My oldest Stanley's dead and gone, I swear it.
Oh, here is love, and here is truth, and here is smooth, more joyous laughter. She will be faithful to her sooth, till we are wed and even after. Oh, here is love, and here is truth.
Oh, here is love, and here is truth.
She will be faithful to her sooth,
till
we are wed and even after.
Till we are wed
and even after. Oh, here is love, and here is truth, and here is smooth for joyous laughter. She will be faithful to her sooth,
till we are wed and even after.
She will be faithful to her sooth, till we are wed and even after. Even after. Oh, here is love, and here is truth, and here is love.
We are timidly inclined.
And anything but blind.
To the danger that's behind.
Yet when the danger's near. We manage to appear. As insensible to fear as anybody here.
Sergeant, approach. Young Frederick was to have led you to death and glory.
That be not a pleasant way of putting it.
No matter. He will not so lead you, for he has allied himself once more with his old associates.
He has acted shamefully.
You speak falsely. You know nothing about it. He has acted nobly.
He has acted nobly.
Dearly as I loved him before, his heroic sacrifice to his sense of duty has endeared him to me tenfold. He has done his duty. I will do mine. Go ye and do yours.
Right-o.
This be perplexing.
We cannot understand it at all.
Still, as he is actuated by his sense of duty.
That makes a difference, of course. At the same time, we repeat, we cannot understand it at all.
No matter. Our course is clear. We must do our best to capture these pirates alone.
It is most distressing to us to be the agents whereby our erring fellow creatures are deprived of that liberty which is so dear to all. But we should have thought of that before we joined the force.
We should.
It'd be too late now.
It be.
Where when a felon's not engaged in his employment.
His employment.
Or maturing his felonious little plan.
Little plan.
His capacity for innocent enjoyment.
Innocent enjoyment.
Is just as great as any honest man.
Honest man.
Our feelings are we with a difficulty smother.
Difficulty smother.
When constabulary duties do be done.
To
I take one consideration with another.
With another.
A policeman's lot is not a happy one. Oh,
when constabulary duties to be done, a policeman's lot is not a happy one. Happy
when the enterprising burglar's not a burgling.
Not a burgling.
And the cutthroat isn't occupied in crime.
I in crime.
He loves to hear the little brook a gurgling.
Brook a gurgling.
And listen to the merry village chime.
Village chime.
The village chime.
When the coster's finished jumping on his mother.
On his mother.
He loves to lie a-basking in the sun.
In the sun.
I take one consideration with another.
With another.
A policeman's lot is not a happy one. When constabulary duties to be done, to be done. A policeman's lot is not a happy one. Happy one.
Tarot.
we steal, in silence dread, our cautious way we feel. No sound at all, we never speak a word, a fly's footfall would be distinctly heard. Take another station. Let's bury piracy. With a little burglary, we cut like tread. Out on our frame, we steal. In silence, red, a cautious way. We
not a word. I see a light inside. The Major General comes. So quickly hide.
Yes, yes, the Major General comes.
Yes, yes, the Major General comes.
Yes, yes, the Major General comes. Tormented with the anguish, dread of falsehoods unatorn. I lay upon my sleepless bed and tossed and turned and groaned. The man who finds his conscience ache, no peace at all enjoys. And as I lay in bed awake, I thought I heard a noise.
He thought he heard a noise.
Ha! Hurt you!
Entail on him, my mind is set at ease. So still the scene, it must have been the sighing of the priest. Softly to the river comes the loving breeze, setting nature all a quiver, rustling through the trees.
Through the trees.
And the brook in rippling measure laughs the very life, while the poplars in their pleasure wave their arms above.
Yes, the trees were very long, wave their leafy arms above.
River, river, little river, may thy loving prosper and heaven's dreaming of the dreams, may thy wooing happy be.
Tales of gore could tell, nobody can do so well.
summon your men and effect a capture.
Frederick Seymour!
Beautiful Mabel, I would if I could, but I am not able.
He's telling the truth, he is not able.
With base deceit, you work upon our feelings. Revenge is sweet, and flavors all our dealings. With courage rare, and resolution manly. For death prepare, and happy General Stanley.
Easy to die, and shriven on a nail.
You've contrived, but your proud triumph will not be long-lived.
Don't say you're orphans, for we know that game.
On your allegiance we've a stronger claim. We charge you yield. We charge you yield in Queen Victoria.
Oh, wandering one, walk surely straight. Take heart of grace, thy steps retrace, my wandering ones. Oh, wandering ones, if such poor love as ours can help me find true peace of mind, why take it, it is yours.
Oh, wandering ones.
Pretty little place, I'm guilty. What's the opportunity to make a big difference?